Good morning, commanding officer. We tackle to the HMH-366 change of command ceremony, in which Lieutenant Colonel Nelson Meadows III will relinquish command to Lieutenant Colonel Richard T. Anderson. The commander of troops for today's ceremony is Major Brian J. Taylor. The adjutant is Captain Samuel B. Coombson. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the invocation given by Lieutenant Commander Emery C. Bussey, Marine Aircraft Group 29 Chaplain, United States Navy.
Let's pray. Father, it's always good to come and share a prayer for guys that I know fairly well. First off, I just want to thank you for reminding us of our amphibious roots today, the weather the way it is, and also for this wonderful hangar that we're able to get out of the room. And Lord, I just want to lift up these two men. I just want to lift up Lieutenant Colonel Meadows. He's able now to get back 2 more hours of his life every day without having to make that drive. I just thank you now that he's going to spend it on gas and buy his daughter some shoes so that she can look nice and she can do these kind of things. I pray to you, Father, that as he becomes an exile, they can pick up the pieces there. And I just thank you for the time he's been this morning. Seeing how you're alone, CEO of 366, spent money for you and your family, and that kind of thing. I thank you for the example of the second year, the tenor being set in the bar. So I pray for you, Lieutenant Commanders, as you take over, Father, he maintains that same level of efficiency and excellence as he continues to mold and shape the things here. Father, I just pray that he enjoys that same pride every day and just to spend a few moments with you. And that you just, during that time, just give him a double portion of your wisdom and your spirit to be the leader you're here in this city. Again, Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for the United States of America.
Present-day ceremonies in the Marine Corps have their basis in both history and tradition. The formation online made possible the passing of firepower from those 11 muskets of yesterday. In earlier days, the line of battle was just that, a line of 2 or 3 ranks who looked the line for battle. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Headquarters, Reno, November 2011. The officer of the day is Captain Kiefer. The officer of the day tomorrow is First Lieutenant Dolan. By order of Lieutenant Colonel Halstead Meadows III, United States Marine Corps, Commander. Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the ceremonies for a solemn moment, the actual passing of command. The battle colors of the Marine Corps unit symbolize the authority and accountability of command. Transferring the colors during the ceremony symbolizes the relinquishing of command by Lieutenant Colonel Meadows. By accepting the colors, Lieutenant Colonel Anderson accepts command and confirms his total commitment to the Marines and sailors that he will command. Sergeant Major Banks has delivered the colors to the commanding officer. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the transfer of the squadron colors. From Commanding General, 2nd Marine Aircraft Wing, to Lieutenant Colonel Halstead Meadows III. Subject, Wing Special Order 11-11, effective 1104 November 2011. You stand attached as Commanding Officer Marine Heavy Helicopter Squadron 366. And our director to report to the commanding officer, Marine Aircraft Group 29, for duty as the executive officer. Signed, John M. Davis, Major General, U.S. Marine Corps, Commanding General. From 2nd Marine Aircraft Wing, subject to Attack 11, November 2011. You are directed to report for duty as the commanding officer, Marine and Heavy Helicopter Squadron 366. Signed, John M. Davis, Major General, U.S. Marine Corps, Commanding General. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Lieutenant Colonel Meadows, inbred as you relinquish command, you can take pride in the accomplishments of your squadron and in the performance of your Marines and sailors. During your tenure, the Hammerheads provided outstanding support to operations around the world. Congratulations on the job well done. Best wishes to you and Tracy in all your future endeavors. For Lieutenant Colonel Anderson, Tibby, your past assignments have prepared you well for command. Best wishes to you and Stephanie for success in the rewarding and challenging days ahead. J.M. Davis, Major General, Commander. Ladies and gentlemen, Lieutenant Colonel Halstead Meadows III.
Scratch your head and go, that's buzzer thing. Those of you guys who know are out there, they helped help make me what I am. And actually, when you go through that list of names, too, they talk to about especially in the room. Fought the nation's battles in Afghanistan, Iraq, the Horn of Africa twice, one of you all over the bed. There are no finer on this planet, and it has been my true pleasure and my honor to serve with you, not to have a little part of your leadership, but just to be a part of your family. And I appreciate everything that you have done for me in making this water what it is today. So God love you, I have a hand. All right, last Tim Steph. I will tell you that they are a quality family. As I look throughout my Marine Corps career, and I look at everything that I've done, and I look at everybody that's available out there, there is nobody in the world that I would give this one to more than you. Not because I'm ready to get rid of you, but because of the leader that you are. You're a friend and a brother. You're going to do great things. So, bye.
Colonel Richard T. Anderson.
Colonel Jensen, Colonel Regan. Colonel Mrs. Lennon, Colonel Zora, Colonel Ewan. And Master Chiefs, family and friends, thank you all for being here today. That started for me very early. With my first CEO, Colonel Anderson. So the fact that I'm standing where I am, getting ready to sit before me, School Waddle, Michael Thompson, soon to be Buzz Morris, Ahab, all across pass here for so that's not an accident. Thank you.
I was lucky enough to be an excellent with Operation
Lindbergh. It was an honor to serve with you and watch out. Yeah, don't cry hard, certainly something I'm proud of. Jay Fonda, Sergeant Lunchford, Sergeant Pratkin, certainly starting for your appreciative for being positive. Thank you. Trey and Tracy Meadows, man, it is definitely to take your friends that watch this go down a few different times. I know that this water is a gift. That's the way you have done your business here, your product, and your professional leadership, and we're each prepared because of it. Tracy, likewise, I can't agree with this program and are not paid for it. I know that Steph is benefiting from that as well. So thank you both. I know we get this water. To the families, I just want to let you know that Steph and I are still committed to the involvement and dedication that everybody's had. We've been with you through what I believe is a challenging time now, certainly a challenging 18 months. We stand there right behind you. I'm ready to make sure that you guys are central and whatever you need. A lot of sacrifice for the families, certainly stuff you know about them just as much as anyone else. Shoulder to shoulder with those who are better. So thank you. You're a really good teacher. Lastly, the Marines. But I'll tell you quick. I had a chance to work with the meeting before they left for about 2.5 months. And then I got a chance to sort of find the holiday before they left. So I know how prepared they were. I know the basically where those guys were going out the door, a lot of professionalism, the dedication, and certainly being more and more down there on division accomplishment. The last 6 months I've had an opportunity to fly and work with all of you. And I know that that is still the same. That is a hallmark of this water.
Thank you, Semper Fi.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Meadows and Mrs. Anderson. The donation. And at this time, Lieutenant Colonel Anderson would like to invite his father and Lieutenant Colonel Meadows' father to join them.